With the Euros around the corner and the link to Chelsea still there, Declan Rice's name has been in many a football conversation recently. However, it seems as though the dialogue around him is very split. Either you love him or you hate him. On top of this, it seems as though members of both sides misunderstand what Declan Rice really is and what he could bring to a team. This inspired me to take a look at the youngster. In this video, we'll be looking at what type of player he is and just how good that player is. Before that, here's a little something to whet your appetite. Do you think you're better off alone. Let's start off with his role and position. Under David Moyes, West Ham looked to sit back in defensive banks, absorbing opposition pressure while looking to pounce on a loose or lost ball to try and inflict deadly damage. Rice is more often than not deployed in the middle of the second bank of four, as seen in his heat map. His responsibility is to remain positionally disciplined and also to be aggressive in trying to snuff out any potential attacks. At 1.85 meters tall, he, along with Thomas Soucek, who is 1.92 meters tall, form a physically dominant pairing at the heart of midfield, and their primary objective is to protect the back four behind them. That is where the majority of Rice's strengths lie. As this chart shows, he's a very active defender, especially when compared to other under 23 players in the Premier League. This is particularly true on the interception front, where he's in the 95th percentile amongst all midfielders in the Premier League. That means he's in the top 5% of all midfielders for interceptions per 90. This indicates that he's more than just a bruising, hard-tackling giant. It shows that he has an exceptional understanding of the game, and is able to read the game in such a manner that allows him to be one step ahead of the opposition and put a stop to their attacks. Here's an example of that ability. Rice is in his usual position in the middle of the park. He is positioned here to prevent passes through the middle. However, he's intelligent enough to read the way in which the opposition player shapes his body and recognize where he's likely to pass. He then immediately darts into the space between the passer and the intended receiver and is able to come away with the ball and regain possession for his team. This is not to say he's afraid of getting stuck in. As you probably saw in the montage earlier, he's a very good tackler. While he's able to use his physical gifts to overwhelm defenders, it's usually his timing and decision making which allows him to make many of these tackles. He understands when to put a foot in and when to hold off. This is something that has improved a lot this season. This is shown by the fact that he is almost half as likely to get a yellow card this season than in his previous two seasons, indicating that he's able to maintain his defensive output while becoming more disciplined. He's also very good on the ball. The most interesting aspect of his game is his ability to play very accurate long balls over the top. This chart shows that he's not quite amongst the very best youngsters in the Premier League, but still very good. Here's an example of how he uses this ability. In this game for England in the Nations League, he picks up the ball just in front of the defense. He then uncorks a lovely long ball over the top, which bypasses the midfield, and the result is England are able to advance the ball up the field and get into a better attacking position. His dribble numbers are also fairly decent at 1.08 dribbles per 90, which puts him in the 68th percentile, meaning he's in the top 32% in the league amongst midfielders. Overall, at 22 years old, the future looks very bright for Rice. There are some limitations on his abilities, but he's so much more than many people think, and I think he can offer a lot both in attack and defense. I'm excited to see what the future holds for him, and you should definitely keep an eye on him. Well, that's it for this video. If you did enjoy it, please politely tap that like button, and if you are new around here, please don't forget to subscribe, and if you do have any suggestions or players you'd like me to look at, please put them in the comments down below. And until next time, it's been your boy, Zachary McAllister. Have a good day.